People spend an average of about 52 minutes daily on TikTok. The app has become ingrained into pop culture, and the thing holding it all together? Music. But how did we get here? Music has not only been an important part of internet culture, but it's been an essential part of every culture throughout the globe. It's an art form, a source of entertainment. When the moving image was invented, the idea of a music video was immediately thought of. Music videos shook the industry, and it's never been the same since. The moving image was invented to figure out if all of a horse's hooves lift off the ground at the same time while it gallops. And it was invented by a man who murdered his wife's alleged lover. This man, who was acquitted on the grounds of justifiable homicide, was Edward James Muybridge. The 11-frame moving image, fittingly named The Horse in Motion, was released in 1879. And if you somehow don't know already, a horse does, in fact, lift all 4 feet off the ground while galloping. The first motion picture would be released in 1888 by Louis Le Prince, and was instantly regarded as the best film ever made. I feel sorry for the people in 1888 who blinked and missed the whole 4-frame movie. Motion pictures took a while to have sound. It was not until 1923 when the motion pictures with sound on film were presented. They would often feature popular musicians such as vaudeville stars and opera singers.
Wait a minute, you ain't heard nothing yet.
The first full-length talkie, which is the word they use for movies with dialogue, was The Jazz Singer in 1927. It contains the staples of roaring 20s cultures such as flappers and blackface. However, what is often cited as the first music video was released more than two decades prior, in 1895. It was made for the kinetophone, a device invented in Thomas Edison's lab by William Dixon. The film was fittingly titled Dixon Experimental Sound Film, and was played together with a wax cylinder for the soundtrack. But it was never released to the public because people just did not care about the kinetophone. Rip Dixon. Fast forward several decades to the 1940s, and we have the precursor to the modern music video, soundies. Movies, talkies, soundies, people are not very creative with names apparently. Anyways, they were usually only a few minutes long, and would be viewed on jukebox-like machines called panorams. For a coin, you could watch a soundie at a bar, restaurant, nightclub, or any place you'd think a jukebox would be. And there were tons of soundies. Turner Classic Movies notes that they're pretty great for preserving early music styles and are actually very important for the record they left of early African-American artists. As television became more popular, soundies, of course, became obsolete. The history of music videos also became pretty convoluted, so I'll try to summarize it the best I can. In 1959, Giles Richardson, more commonly known as the Big Bopper, coined the term music video. At the time, rock and roll stars such as the King, Elvis Presley, would perform on the television. And then the British invaded America again. The very obscure British boy band, the Beatles, were innovative in many ways. One such way was their combination of movies and music. One of the biggest ways they marketed their music was through film. They starred in movies about themselves, very humble, and they made promotional clips to market individual records. The first music video on television was We Can Work It Out by the Beatles in 1965. It was simple, but it got the point across. The Beatles would slowly become more experimental with videos such as Strawberry Fields and Penny Lane, and Strawberry Fields Forever. Strawberry Fields. And by experimental, I also mean more psychedelic and more odd. Other artists such as Bob Dylan, Pink Floyd, and the Rolling Stones would follow the Beatles' example. Is this the real life? Is this just fantasy? In the 70s, Queen's Bohemian Rhapsody video would become iconic and greatly influence the music videos following it. And then, the video finally killed the radio star. Sort of. I heard you on the wireless back in 52, lying awake intently tuning in on you. If I was young, it didn't stop you coming through. Oh, oh. MTV launched in 1981, and its first music video basically explains the impact the music video would have on the music industry. They even called the hosts VJs instead of DJs. In this decade, there'd be tons of iconic music videos airing on MTV. Arguably, the most iconic music video was Thriller by Michael Jackson. It had the budget of a feature film and looked like one too, and set the bar of what a music video could look like. Now, MTV would continue to be popular, but it would slowly phase out music videos for TV shows since TV shows just tended to have higher ratings. However, music videos weren't gone yet because a new platform would suddenly emerge. YouTube released in 2006, and it would quickly become the perfect place for music videos to release. People could search and watch music videos on demand. Even smaller bands could release viral music videos with barely any budget. To this day, music videos are still released onto YouTube, and they receive up to billions of views. The most viewed music video, Despacito, has more views than there are people on the planet. Of course, the main reason for music videos has always been to promote the song and the singer. This started with the Beatles and is still true today. Before TV, songs really only got popular through radio shows, and the only way to see a singer perform was live in person. The radio never completely died, but the music industry had to use music videos as one of the main platforms for singers to get attention. This meant that the music industry had to collaborate with the movie industry and even Hollywood. Although advertisement was the main reason behind music videos for the production companies, artists often used music videos as a sort of artistic extension of the song. Some music videos could even change the meaning of a song. Although music videos are still popular, songs don't really seem to become popular because of them anymore. With streaming apps such as Spotify showing the most popular songs and social media apps such as TikTok popularizing songs, the music video has had to shift their focus elsewhere. Years later, and no music video has beaten Despacito in terms of views. Well, except for Baby Shark, but that does not count. And I'm also not going to play any of that. But it could be argued that applications such as TikTok are the new form of music video. They're videos that are created not necessarily by the artists, but by the fans. The music industry doesn't necessarily need to spend millions on music videos. They just need the song to become a trend. Now, as we have seen and I've talked about over the last couple of minutes, people have wanted to combine music with film since the very conception of the moving image. Now, although music videos are not as important as they once were, they're just too ingrained into the music industry to be going away anytime soon. But who knows? Maybe some new thing will one day kill the video star.